Hey guys, give me 1 second if you will. Mr. Walker here. Welcome to another math lesson with Mr. Walker. Sorry that I'm eating in the middle of a math lesson, but just got some Sour Patch Kids, and I love Sour Patch Kids, but so does like everybody else in the house. So when we get them, I gotta scarf them down, or else they're gone. So I'm just trying to eat a couple real quick before everybody else discovers that they're here. So guys, just bear with me for a second. But anyway, for today, my learning goal for today, which is representing and solving division problems and all sorts of stuff, up to 3 digits in the dividend, which is a number that we're dividing, obviously, numerically, and with place value disk and all sorts of stuff. So just give me one. Man, those are good. So, you know, like I said, these are popular in my household. Actually, my Mrs. Walker, she really loves them. And one of my daughters likes them. The other one, not so much. But I basically have to keep them away from them. So I'm going to just get a couple more in real quick. You know, guys, I'm kind of starting to regret my choice of scarfing these down real quick, because not only is it not sitting right in my stomach, but I feel a little guilty. So I still have some of the bag left here, and I'm wondering if maybe if it would have been a little bit nicer if I were to share these with Miss Walker and my daughter, instead of just being gluttonous and eating them all myself. Although they were delicious, but I'm not sure if it's the guilt or the sourness that's hitting me here. But you know what? Maybe I should divide up the rest of this bag and see if they want it. And you know, divide up the rest of the bag. That's a great segue, because that's actually what we're working on today, right? I put up that goal earlier, but our main kind of learning for today is to be able to divide 3-digit numbers by any numbers, and we're going to use place value disks and even take a look at the standard algorithm for division as well. So maybe we can work something out here. So why don't you guys go ahead and get something to write on, something to write with. If you do happen to have a place value chart, that can come in handy as well. So if you want to grab one of those. If not, I'm going to have one drawn up here, so you guys can kind of just draw it and sketch it out with me. And then grab that stuff, press pause, and when you're ready, come back and maybe you can help me out with my little division stomach ache quandary here. All right, I'll see you in a second. Alright guys, if I shake this bag and what I have remaining left here, it seems like I have probably right around 423 Sour Patch Kids left in there. Yeah, I'd say that's about right. So, I like them, Miss Walker likes them, and my daughter likes them. So we're going to have to divide that 423 that's left, we're going to have to divide that by 3, okay, to make sure that everybody gets an equal amount. Now, I know I already ate a bunch of them, but don't tell them that, they don't need to know that. But want to make sure that what's left, that everybody gets an equal amount of what's left. So I have a place value chart here, right? And it's showing our hundreds, our tens, and our ones. And let me go ahead and just add a line in here so we can kind of keep those separate there. And the first thing when we're dividing these big numbers like this, one of the first things we want to do, and when we're finding the quotient, which if you don't remember, the quotient is the answer to a division problem. One of the first things we want to do is kind of break apart that number 423 and take a look at what it's really worth, like what each of those digits are representing worth-wise. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to draw in 400s here. Okay, I just put 4 circles in there, no big deal. I'm going to put in 2 tens, all right, 2 tens. And 3 ones for the 3 in the ones place. 1, 2, 3. Okay. Well, you guys, if you haven't done that already, go ahead and if you don't have a place value chart, sketch one out that looks similar to mine. Doesn't have to be perfect, but draw some lines, draw some boxes, 100s, 10s, 1s, and put in your 100s, 10s, and 1s using your place value disks if you have them, or just draw dots like me. Okay. Go ahead and get that, and then come back in, and we'll go a little bit further. Well, as I said, with the Sour Patch Kids that are remaining, I'm going to divide them among the 3 of us, right? 3 of us. So basically, we're going to end up with 3 groups. 1, 2, 3. So we can even say Mr. Walker, Mrs. Walker, and my daughter. We're going to divide them among the 3. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take each one of these dots in the place value, basically, and I'm going to move them down into each group and divide them out that way, okay? So let's start with my hundreds here. And on mine, because I have my super cool smart board, I'm actually going to be able to move my dots. You might not be able to on your side of things if you're drawing on a paper. If you can do that after drawing on a paper, let me know, because that'd be super cool. But if not, you could just cross it out. And maybe I'll just do that instead to make it a little bit easier. So I'm going to take this 100 here, okay? And I'm going to put this 100 there for myself. I'm going to take this next 100. I'm going to put it down here for Mrs. Walker. And this next 100 and put it down here for my daughter. So we have 1, 2, 300 that we're able to share among us. So each of us so far is going to get 100 Sour Patch Kids. Not bad. I still have this 100 left here, though. And if I try to move it, if I try to move it for myself, well, that's going to give me an extra 100. If I move it to Miss Walker or my daughter, that's going to give them an extra 100. So that's not really going to work out. So what can I do with that 100? How can I maybe break it up or do something with it to make it more easy for me to divide? Well, you are exactly right. I could take that. Let me cross out these guys with red so we can keep my color coded here. But I could take that 100, and I'm going to bring it over here to my tens, and I'm going to bring it over as 10 tens, because that's the same value, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, so now I have 10 tens that I added in. Instead of that 100. So I just kind of took that 100 and split it up into the tens, which is easy enough. All right, so now that I have that 100 divided up into tens, now I can start to move these guys too. So I'm going to move this 10 here. This 10 I'm going to put here. This 10 I'm going to put here. I'm going to keep going with that. You guys kind of get the idea. All right, awesome. So I have all those tens divided out now, so that's good to go. I'm gonna actually also bring down these lines so I can keep this straight and organized and know that these are my hundreds, these are my tens, and now I'm gonna do the ones next, right? So coming over here to the ones, I'm gonna bring this guy here for myself, this one for Miss Walker, this one for my daughter, and there we go. So I have everything divided up here. There's nothing left up here anymore. Even that 100 that I brought over as the 10 tens, then we divided that up. So we're good to go. So if I look for myself, I'm going to have 100 and 1, 2, 3, 4 tens, 1, 1. 100, 40, 1. So that's going to be how many Sour Patch Kids that I get. And if we look, Miss Walker gets 100, 4 tens, 1, 1. She's going to get the same amount. And my daughter will get the same amount as well. And as for my other daughter, we'll probably just have to give her some M&Ms or something. That's one of her favorites. So we're good to go there. So we were able to divide. I was able to divide up the rest of these Sour Patch Kids between the three of us, and we would each get 141 Sour Patch Kids. Not too shabby there. So a three-digit dividend, number that we're dividing by, we were able to go through and get our quotient, our answer, of 141. Pretty exciting. Pretty exciting stuff. So I don't know about you guys, but that was kind of fun. You want to try another one real quick? All right, cool. Let's try another one. All right, so I realize not everybody said yay out there about doing another division problem, but actually, we're going to do another example. It's going to be pretty cool because we're going to start to make the transition to make the jump towards using the standard algorithm. So we don't have to draw out the place value chart every time and draw dots and all that kind of stuff, which is a great strategy to use if that's what you need to use and you feel comfortable. But we want to start transitioning to that standard algorithm. I'm going to show you what that looks like as we go through with this one, okay? So our number here is 783, and we're dividing that by 3. So our dividend, again, is 783. Our divisor is 3, that's what we're dividing by, and our quotient is gonna be whatever answer we get. So down here, again, we're gonna have 3 groups, okay? So 1, 2, 3 groups, and we're dividing that 783. So the first thing I could do, again, is I could draw my 700s, my 810s, and my 3 ones. Okay, so we got that set up. I represented my 783 in the place value chart. To come over here, but I'm also gonna come over here and I'm going to use the standard algorithm and divide 783 by 3. Okay, so this is how we would set it up using the standard algorithm. We're putting it inside our division symbol here, and we can go through the same way. And we're gonna see those connections that we could make as we do that, all right? So let's start by taking our 700s, okay, 700s that we have, and let's start by dividing them by the 3 using place value. So I'm going to take this 100 and put it here. This 100 will go here. This one's gonna go here. Alright, so I end up here being able to cross out six of those hundreds, but I still got this 100 left over here. Okay, so let's take a look at that for a second. Actually, we're gonna take a look at it by coming over here to our standard algorithm side. Because just like we did down here, if I put two in each of those three groups, if I put two in each of those three groups, that would give me six, right? That's gonna take care of six of those hundreds, which means if I subtract now, seven minus six would give me one left over, which is exactly what I have right here, all right? Now, let's move on to the next step of taking that 100, and I'm gonna bring it over here as 10 tens. All right, so when I bring it over here as 10 tens, I now have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, right? Now let's come over here and do my next step of my standard algorithm, which would be to look at my tens, which I now have 18 tens. So we have to subtract and then bring down that next number, which would give me 18 tens, okay, or 108 tens, right? So we're gonna move into that tens place here and figure out how many groups or how many would be in each group of three. So I'm gonna go ahead and let's see, I'll switch to a different color here. Let's go back to our red. We can go this guy here, two, three. If you guys haven't done it, I'm sorry I haven't stopped in a while, but kind of gone, I'm excited about this. If you haven't already grouped out your 100 into 10 tens and then start moving those tens into the three groups, go ahead and do that and see what you end up with, and then we'll come back and talk about it. All right, so I was able to go through and take those 18 tens and divide them into three groups, which gave me 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 in each group, six in each group. So that means if I come over here to the standard algorithm side of things, there was six in each group, 6 times 3 is 18. Then I could subtract those two and I don't have any tens left. There's no tens left. Nothing I have to bring over, nothing else I have to do there. So now I just gotta bring down my next number, which is a 3, and that's the three ones that I have left, okay? So I can keep going from here, put these guys down, and there we go, we got nothing else left. So I ended up with 1 in each group. If I take that 3 and divide it by 3, I'm gonna get 1 in each group. 1 times 3 will give me 3, subtract, and we have nothing left there. So that's awesome. So we're able to walk through the steps, not only visually with our area model there and our place value and those dots, but also using our standard algorithm. So either way, we can start to be able to divide these numbers, these three-digit dividends, by any numbers there. One little tip I'm gonna throw out there, take it or leave it, and I know it's gonna sound a little bit silly, but that's me, that's what I do, is one acronym, which is letters that each letter stands for a word. One acronym that I've always remembered is called Dirty Monkeys Smell Bad, okay? Sounds ridiculous. I've never actually smelled a monkey, a dirty monkey even, but I'm assuming they smell pretty bad. If you take that, Dirty Monkeys Smell Bad, and think about each letter, D, M, S, B, we have divide, which is what our first step was over here, to divide 7 by 3. And then we did 3 times 2, that's the multiply, to get 6. So the first step is to divide 7 by 3. The next step would be multiply by whatever we get when we do the division. And that gave us 6. Then we subtract, that's our next letter is to subtract. And then we bring down, that's the 8. Divide, multiply, subtract, bring down. If that helps you to at least remember the steps, use it. If not, if you have some other way, that's totally fine too. Just a little trick I used to use. So, this has been fun. You know what would be even more fun? One more example. Let me put up one more for you, and then I'll let you guys go for today. All right, here's our last example we're gonna take a look at. We're dividing by 3 again, so we're kind of staying with a common theme, but we have 546. That is the number that we are dividing. That is our dividend, our divisor is 3. We're going to be looking for the quotient or the answer. So go ahead and take a stab at this one, take a shot at this one. Let me know what you get. I want you to do the model here, model it out using the place value chart and see if you can do the standard algorithm as well. So you guys give that a shot and then we'll come back and we'll talk about it. All right, guys, I got this example up here. Hopefully you guys had a chance to try it out. Let's walk through some of the steps together and make sure that we got to the same place, okay? So I have that 546 that I'm dividing by 3. I'm gonna go ahead and start over here with the standard algorithm and then make that connection back to the place value model this time, okay? So I have the number 5. I'm gonna divide it into groups of 3. That means each one of my groups is only going to have one of those hundreds in it, okay? 3 times 1 would give me 3. I can't do 2 or anything like that. That's gonna be too much. So I'm going to just have 1 in each group. So it's going to give me 3. I'm going to subtract, right? That's my next step. Subtract. 5 minus 3 is going to give me 2. So that means I should have 2 hundreds left over when I come over to this side. Okay? 2 hundreds left over. I'm going to bring it down, basically put it into tens. If I add it to my tens, that's going to give me 24 tens. 24 tens. I'm still in the tens place here. Okay? So taking that 24 and dividing it by 3. If I divide it by 3, I'm going to get 8 in each group. 3 times 8 is going to give me 24. Subtract, that will give me 0. I don't have any tens left, right? But I still got this 6 in the ones place, so I'm going to bring that down. And here we go. And now we have 6 divided by 3. That's going to give me 2. 3 times 2 is 6. Subtract, and there's none left over. So let's see if we can go back over here to the place value chart and make sure that it works out the same way and that we get the same answer. So if I take those 500s, I'm gonna put one of them here. Would you look at this? See, if I keep crossing these out, I run out. And this group has 2, this group has 2, but this one only has 1. So I can't do that. I gotta make it even. So let me step back a bit here. And I'm going to have to bring these 200s over as 10 tens for one of them and 10 tens for another one. So let me do that. Okay, so I brought over 10 tens and another 10 tens, so that gives me 20 tens, and the 4 tens that I have here, that's 24. That's the same number that I had here, right? Same thing. So now I can take these tens and put them in the groups of 3, get a different color. All right, so when I put all of those tens in those 3 different groups, I end up with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 8 tens in each group, right? 8 tens, which we've got over here, that gave me, I used up all 24 of them. We subtract, I didn't have any left. I brought down the 6, we're good to go. And I just realized, guys, because I was so excited about solving this, that I never drew in all of my 1s to begin with. Holy cow, what a mess. But anyway, now I can take these 1s here, these 6 1s that are left, and I could put them, one here, I could put them all there, which gives me 2 in each group. 2 in each group. I subtract. I'm left with no ones here. I don't have any tens left. And then these hundreds, they both got moved over to here. All right. Whew, that was our last example. Hopefully that makes sense. Hopefully you can start to make that connection between our place value, using the place value, moving those dots, and being able to use the standard algorithm as well. So whichever one you feel more comfortable with, stick with that, but we are going to start to transition to that standard algorithm, so do start to familiarize yourself with that as we go through. So all right, guys, we divided 3-digit dividends today by a divisor. We were able to walk through using 2 different strategies. We did an awesome job. If you guys have any questions, comments, or concerns, please reach out and let me know. But I do appreciate you guys following along with me, having some fun. I got a lot of sugar coursing through me right now. I'm talking kind of fast. I think I need to go get some water to wash down all that Sour Patch Kid sugar. But thank you guys. Have a great rest of your day. We'll talk to you soon.